CTV News at 6 with Hudson Mack.
Good evening. Time may be running out on Occupy Victoria. The protesters could be forced to pack up and move on a lot sooner than they might have liked. The city of Victoria says that it needs Centennial Square and needs all of it in less than 3 weeks. CTV's Andrew Johnson has the latest tonight on the situation and joins us live just across the street from the campout. Andrew.
Hudson, the city and Victoria Police have also released just how much the Occupy protest has cost taxpayers, and the figures might surprise you.
A friendly conversation between Occupy Victoria and the Victoria Police, but also an expensive one. Vic PD says keeping an eye on Centennial Square has cost $20,000, and officers are seeing more people they've met before.
Well, certainly the demographic has changed a lot down in the square. We're seeing a lot of the people that we've known for a long time. The demographic is more to the street-entrenched people that are using this as a tent city now.
The city of Victoria says if you add up bylaw enforcement in the square, extra cleanup and staff time, it has spent an additional $40,000 on Occupy Victoria, and like police, doesn't like the way the campout is evolving.
Overflowing needle boxes suggesting a higher drug use in the square, more garbage, more evidence of human excrement, more cleanup required of our public washrooms that are open 24/7.
The city says it still supports peaceful assembly and protest, but it is now clear protesters will be asked to pack up and leave in less than 3 weeks.
Ultimately, we do require the entire square for those events.
The city and the Downtown Business Association say the tree light up coinciding with the Santa Claus parade and the outdoor skating rink installation means workers will need access to the entire square sometime before November 21st.
Is there room for the protesters and your lights and ice rink and celebration?
I'm afraid there isn't. You know what? We have genuinely tried to work in the spirit of cooperation with them, but the way that things are evolving at the present time, you know what, it would be best if they simply acknowledge that there are others who need this space.
The tens of thousands of people who want to enjoy this square, come down, watch the tree light up and skate, are able to do that. We don't need a tent city holding that hostage.
There are also indications businesses are getting tired of their new neighbors.
Next door to Occupy Victoria, staff at the Satin Moon Quilt Shop say they were approached by a protester who demanded to use their power and said if they didn't let him, he'd have tents set up outside their door. Meantime, at the Starbucks here, business is up because the corporate coffee shop has become an unlikely but popular Occupy Victoria nighttime hangout.
Occupiers acknowledge they're having a difficult time policing their own ranks, but they say they have no plans to leave.
My plan is to stay as a camper until there's change, some social change, some social justice comes to this situation.
At this point, it appears he may be asked to go much sooner.
Hudson, what's happening in Victoria seems to be in line with the latest Occupy developments across the country today. In Vancouver, fire officials have made a deadline for safety improvements. Campers are being told to stop using open flames and propane tanks and also to space out their tents farther. They're also being told to remove large tarps, which actually hindered first responders trying to get to an overdose patient. And in Quebec City, the mayor has told occupiers they have to pack up their tents now or police will move in and do it for them.
You know, Andrew, you mentioned Starbucks, and I think that underscores that maybe the message here is getting lost. This started out as kind of an anti-corporate movement, and, you know, if they're going to Starbucks in the evening, that kind of flies in the face of what they say they're there for.
Well, in talking to these people, Hudson, it seems like there's just so many different groups out in the square right now that maybe a lot of people wouldn't approve of the ones going for coffee to Starbucks, but they can't stop them from doing it. They wouldn't do it themselves, and here goes the confusion.
Keep an eye on what happens next. Andrew Johnson, thanks.
You're welcome.